Greetings to all subscribers. Today, we will delve into the detailed basic steps for evaluating lateral elbow pain, including basic physical tests and exploring the ultrasound characteristics of tendon pathology. Additionally, we'll learn how to interpret these findings by correlating them with real-time ultrasound-guided injection procedures. For those in the advanced class, I will offer a detailed strategy to explain the pathology to patients and present an advanced treatment approach using Botox combined with whole blood to manage torn tendons, exclusively for our premium members. When assessing the pain by physical examination in the lateral elbow, I conduct passive flexion, extension, pronation, and supination tests with my patient. Additionally, I perform a resisted wrist extension test to assess the extensor tendon. During these tests, you will likely observe the patient's pain response through their body language, particularly when I execute the extend and flex movements and the wrist resisted test. Next, we will proceed with the ultrasound examination. I invite you to closely follow both the ultrasound probe and the patient's images. I'll show the entire ultrasound examination process without editing the video for a comprehensive understanding. We will start with a longitudinal scan of the extensor tendon, positioning the elbow in 90 degrees of flexion and pronation. Here, you should be able to observe a linear echogenic line, areas of low echogenicity and the deep insertional area of the ECRB, and focal low echogenicity in the collateral ligament. This finding suggests that the tear involves the deep tendon and the collateral ligament. Switching to a transverse axis view of the extensor tendon, we will see focal low echogenicity and a heterogeneous echo texture indicative of torn fibers. Next, I will reevaluate the tendon fibers with the elbow in full extension, examining the insertional tendon in longitudinal and transverse scan images. We will then proceed to evaluate the deep radial nerve. The scan starts above the elbow crease, tracking the radial nerve in its intermuscular fascial plane between the brachialis and brachioradialis muscles. As we follow the radial nerve in a transverse scan, we will identify the separation of the superficial and deep radial nerves, focusing more on the deep radial nerve. Meticulous attention is given to the deep radial nerve as it traverses Froese's canal, located at the entrance between the two muscle bundles of the supinator muscle. We will compare the nerve size in this space before and after Froese's canal. Subsequently, we will assess the coronoid fossa to evaluate fluid levels and joint pathology. If the patient reports pain while lifting objects with the forearm or experiences pain in the anterior elbow, we will include an evaluation for biceps pathology. Typically, the biceps tendon is examined using only a longitudinal scan. However, we will also check with a transverse scan, particularly if there is any indication of pathology, effusion, or need for an injection procedure after the examination. Lastly, we will evaluate the olecranon fossa and any effusion present, along with some aspects of the triceps tendon, the anconeus muscle, and the posterior lateral capsule of the humeroradial joint. Let me help you understand the meaning of low echo texture and linear echogenic lines in the context of tendon pathology. Here in the operating room, I will demonstrate the enlarging defect in the torn area of the extensor carpi radialis brevis tendon. I'll show you the ultrasound features of this tendon once again. During the procedure, I will puncture the tendon and inject a whole blood mixture into the torn area. You'll observe me repeatedly pushing and pulling the needle, redirecting it while administering the fluid. Rather than focusing on the process, pay attention to the structures where I inject the fluid and the hydrodistension of the torn area. The linear echogenic line represents the interface between the torn area and the adjacent normal tendon. The hypoechoic area indicates the torn defect of the extensor carpi radialis brevis and the adjacent collateral ligament. On the transverse scan over the epicondyle, you will see a transverse line with varying echogenicity, and you will be able to locate the needle in the transverse view of the extensor carpi radialis brevis. Thank you for watching. I hope this session has helped you understand the abnormal echo texture of the tendon and how it correlates with pathology. I look forward to sharing more in our upcoming videos.